Have you ever wondered? How much fuel do aircraft need to carry? How do you know when you've had enough fuel? Well, here is the answer for that. Regulators such as EASA and the FAA specify the minimum amount of fuel that a passenger jet must carry. Airlines are required to carry significantly more fuel for a flight than is required to get from point A to point B in case of an unexpected event such as an airport closure or aircraft emergency. Commercial flights typically carry at least 1 hour's worth of extra fuel on top of what is required to get to their destination, but this is frequently increased by the pilots depending on the day's circumstances. Airlines must adhere to regulatory requirements when transporting fuel. The majority of government policies are broadly similar and are detailed in each airline's operating manual. According to EASA regulations, which are very similar to those of the FAA and other authorities, the captain must ensure that he has the following minimum fuel before departure. 1. Travel fuel. 2. If a flight is planned with no alternate, divert fuel or hold fuel for 15 minutes. 3. Fuel reserve. 4. Emergency fuel. 5. Taxi fuel. 6. Additional fuel. Let's discuss each fuel and its usage. 1. Trip fuel. Fuel required from takeoff to touchdown, assuming departure on the SID from the assumed runway and arrival using the STAR for the assumed arrival runway and routing based on the forecast wind. 2. Diversion fuel. Fuel consumed during the go-around at the destination, as well as the climb, cruise, descent, approach, and landing at the alternate airport of choice. Normally, this is calculated as the planned landing weight minus the contingency fuel. If no alternate flight is planned, the diversion fuel figure must be replaced by 15 minutes of holding fuel at 1,500 feet above the destination airfield in standard conditions. 3. Reserve fuel. Is there a minimum amount of fuel that must be present in tanks at the alternate airfield or destination if no planned alternate? The figure is based on 30 minutes of fuel holding at 1,500 feet in a clean configuration with a planned landing weight. 4. Contingency fuel. This is done to account for unanticipated deviations from the planned operation. For example, different winds or temperatures than predicted, or ATC restrictions on levels and speed. It can be used at any time after delivery, once aircraft moves under its own power. It cannot be planned to be used previously. It is more likely to be used for flight or arrival delays. 5. Taxi fuel. This is fuel for the APU to burn on the ground, start the engine, and taxi out. Most airlines calculate this using statistical data and the taxi time in minutes. 6. Additional fuel. If the existing total fuel is insufficient to cover an engine failure or depressurization at the most critical point along the route, additional fuel is planned and loaded. Fuel planning must allow for a descent and trip fuel to an alternate airfield, a 15-minute hold at 1,500 feet, and an approach and landing. Share your thoughts about aircraft fuel and its categories. If you like our video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel.